friends who carpool with me who are also not paid teachers. I'm representing Creation Justice Ministries, a Christian organization serving 38 communions from Orthodox, Baptist, mainline Protestant, historically Black, and Jewish traditions. Through our member communions, we serve about 100,000 churches and 40 million people. The ways in which our member communions practice Christian faith is quite varied. Nevertheless, we are strongly unified in our understanding that if we love our Creator, we must show reverence for all of God's creation. If we follow Jesus, we are called to love our neighbors as ourselves. We are united in our mission to educate, equip, and mobilize people of faith to protect, restore, and rightly share God's creation. An important part of loving our neighbors is looking out for the livelihoods of others so that they may live an abundant life. This includes ensuring that we care for poor communities. Growing up in central Pennsylvania, I understand on a personal level the important contributions coal mining has made to our economy and our communities for decades. I also see that the demand for coal is declining. It is not going to be a preferred source of energy in the near future. We can, as a country, find ways to transition to renewable energy solutions while caring for our coal miners and their families that are struggling because of the decline of the coal mining industry. The solar and wind energy markets are home to the fastest growing job positions offer real opportunities for those looking for a reliable job. I am motivated to care for creation and to love my neighbor as I love myself by a strong faith rooted in a love for all creation, including a love for my brothers and sisters who are most vulnerable. I feel a responsibility to ensure that we can all live healthy, rich lives in which we are able to carry out the plan that God has for us. Yet, air pollution from coal-fired power plants puts our community's health in danger. Also, science clearly shows that carbon dioxide emissions from coal-fired power plants are damaging the temperate climate God has given us. We all count on a stable climate to protect us from extreme weather, natural disasters, to keep coastline communities from flooding, and to be able to grow food. Creation Justice Ministries sees the clean power plant as an important policy tool for protecting our health and our home. Our organization advocated for its establishment. It currently provides the only existing federal limits pollution from power plants. Time is of the essence to protect our community's health and climate. A proposal to remove this safeguard without any clear plan to improve or replace it is most certainly irresponsible. Without a clean power plant or a similar, ideally stronger policy to protect us, we will continue to see premature deaths from pollution-related illnesses and deaths from natural disasters that will only continue to increase in frequency and intensity with the deaths of climate change. This is not something that faith communities are going to sit back and watch happen. We are taking action to show our support of the Clean Power Plan and its purpose. The current proposal to repeal the Clean Power Plan without a clear path to an effective replacement reveals disregard by the Trump administration for the health and safety of all Americans. Instead of repealing without any proposed improvement or replacement, the Clean Power Plan can and should be built upon. At Creation Justice Ministries, we are doing everything